Good evening, welcome to Primetime News. I'm Anupama Suwarna. Right now, the headlines. Concept of homestay must popularize. Boosting tourism needs local awareness. Monsoon comeback in South Karnataka. Rain absent in overall coastal districts. Railway AC fares go high from October 1st. Service charge included, cost 3.70% more. Awareness needs to be created about homestays and myths. The state government has licensed homestays in a bid to boost tourism. The recent attack on the homeless homestay has created a lot of wrong ideas about the concept of homestay. DC Dr. N.S. Chennappa Gowda said at a program held to observe World Tourism Day. Speaking on the need to capitalize on the flow of tourists to Dakshina Kannada, he said that around 90 lakh to 1 crore people visit Dharmasthala, 45 lakh people visit Subramanya, 15 lakh people visit Katil, and 14 lakh people visit Kadri every year, stating that the district has failed to encourage these people to visit other tourist spots. He urged hotels to guide tourists, stating that Dakshina Kannada still has a lot to do in terms of improving infrastructure and providing basic facilities. He said that the district has not accepted tourists the way Kerala and Goa have. Although lakhs of people fly to Mangalore annually, since the city is a medical and educational hub, the district has not used this opportunity to boost tourism.
Nagarada jilleya ee pravasodyavana innu hechina reetiyalli naavu abhivruddhi padisodakke aakarshana madodakke anukoola agutte. Idar jothege ನಮ್ಮ ವಿಮಾನಯಾನ ಪ್ರಯಾಣಿಕರ ಮಂಗಳೂರಿಗೆ ಬರುವುದನ್ನು ನೀವು ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡಾಗ 11-12 ಸಾಲಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಮಾರು 9 ಲಕ್ಷ ಪ್ರಯಾಣಿಕರು ನಮ್ಮ ವಿಮಾನಯಾನದ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇವಲ ಶೇಕಡ 25% ಮಾತ್ರ ವಿದೇಶ, ಅಂದರೆ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಔಟ್ಸೈಡ್ ದಿ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಇರೋರಷ್ಟೇ. ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ಈವನ್ ಡೊಮೆಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲರ್ಸ್ ಈ 75% ಆಫ್ 9 ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್. It was last year, it was 8 lakhs, it has been increased to 1 lakh again. Why they are coming? Not just because of MSCZ here, but maybe there are about 5% of them are coming further. But others are coming indirectly to this place, but you are not noticing such a movement. Adrinda, other jothege, Bengaluru vanna bittare, ಅತಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ವಿದ್ಯಾ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳಿರುವುದು ದಕ್ಷಿಣ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಲಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ವೇರಿಯಬಲಿ ದೇರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಎವರಿ ಇಯರ್.
MUDA Commissioner Ajit Kumar Hegde gave a presentation on homestays and how a homestay ought to be run. According to the rules, the owner of the homestay needs to live in the homestay. Besides, a homestay can have only 5 rooms with a minimum of 2 rooms for tourists. Homestays are also required to provide facilities such as easy access bathrooms, food and so on. The government also considers the educational background of the homestay owner before issuing a license. Speaking on the occasion, the owner of the homestay said that the concept of homestay hasn't picked up in Mangalore, although it works very well in Chikmagalur and Coorg.
ಐದೂವರೆ ಲಕ್ಷದಿಂದ 6 ಲಕ್ಷದವರೆಗೆ ವಿದೇಶಿ ಪ್ರವಾಸಿಗರು ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸುಮಾರು 2.75 ಕೋಟಿ ದೇಶೀಯ ಪ್ರವಾಸಿಗರು ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರವಾಸಿಗರನ್ನು ಒಂದು ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥಿತ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಉಳಿದುಕೊಳ್ಳುವಂಥ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿರುವಂಥ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ಗಳ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಕಾಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಮತ್ತು ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಸಂಖ್ಯೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋದರೆ ವಾಣಿಜ್ಯಿಕವಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಬೆಳೀಬಹುದು. ಆದರೆ ಅದರಿಂದ ಪರಿಸರ ಮಾಲಿನ್ಯ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ತೊಂದರೆಗಳಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಹೋಟೆಲ್ಗಳು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಂಪನಿಯವರು ಬಂದು ಹೋಟೆಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭಿಸಬಹುದು. ಈ ಪ್ರವಾಸೋದ್ಯಮದ ವಿಸ್ತರಣೆಯಿಂದ ಸ್ಥಳೀಯರಿಗೆ ಅನುಕೂಲ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನುವಂತ ಒಂದು ಉದ್ದೇಶದಿಂದ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರವಾಸೋದ್ಯಮ ನೀತಿಯನ್ನ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡಿತು ಈ ಪ್ರವಾಸೋದ್ಯಮ ನೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಯಾವ ಅಂಶಗಳಿದೆ ಅನ್ನುವಂತ ವಿಚಾರವನ್ನ ತಮ್ಮ ಮುಂದೆ ನಾನು
Mayor Gulzar Banu, MCC Commissioner Harish Kumar, KCCI President Mohammed Amin, Assistant Director of Tourism U. Jitendranath, and CEO of Panambur Beach Tourism Development Project Yatish Baikampadi were also present. Now take a short commercial break. Monsoon comeback in South Karnataka, rain absent in overall coastal districts. Railway AC fares go high from October 1st. Service charge included costs 3.70% more.